Hey guys.
Hello, sofa delivery.
Yep.
If you can just check the details and we're just going to get the sofa.
Cool.
All right.
Cheers guys, thank you. Hello.
Hey buddy, what are you up to?
Hey buddy, yeah, well I've just taken the afternoon off just to go through some paperwork and stuff and my new sofas are being delivered.
Yeah, I forgot that was going to happen. You happy with them?
Yeah, all good.
Things are starting to take shape again, aren't they? Leon?
Yeah, sorry mate.
Listen, are you alright mate? Are you okay?
Yeah, no, I'm fine, don't worry.
Okay, well, Andy and Dave are coming around mine later. Thinking a bit of a boys' night, have a couple of drinks. Do you
want
to come?
Yeah, sure. What time do you want me over?
7-ish.
Yeah, sounds good, mate. I'll see you then.
Yeah, ta-da.
Control. There is still a lot of confusion in the area. Again, as many as 73 people are feared dead. Fix Air Boeing 737-400 crashed shortly after takeoff this evening. 58 people were rushed to hospital, 31 are currently in a serious condition. We have been able to speak to several eyewitnesses who told us that they saw an explosion just after the plane took off. Officials have confirmed a terrorist attack being the cause of this crash.
Fucking
Lindsay Barrett
bastards.
Reports. Lindsay.
Thank you, Nancy. Now, as you can see beyond the trees behind me here, the smoke is still visible now. And the chaos and the confusion here is tantamount to the atrocity that occurred earlier when the attack happened.
And it was also stated that the subprime markets in the US were not solely responsible for the recent decline in markets, but also the overall indebtedness caused by the relaxation of those markets. Mm-hmm. 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 Furthermore, a wanted terrorist leader has been named as a suspected mastermind of the attack that was carried out yesterday evening. Anwar Abdel Hussein is said to have been involved in the planning of two suicide bombings in Afghanistan and one attempted bombing 3 months ago in the London Underground. He is said to be hiding in Egypt at the moment. Some passengers who survived the attack have been released from hospital and have returned home. Jason Morgan was one of the passengers on board the Boeing. He only survived because he was asked to change his seat. He told us, people started shouting and screaming while the plane was taking off, but I couldn't see what was happening. He continued, I don't remember anything more after that. He was told that his wife and sister-in-law had died instantly.
It's always going to be like that. It doesn't matter what anti-terrorism laws you bring in. The best one you could possibly use is don't stick your nose in other people's business.
Okay, Mike. So what are they supposed to do? We need to fight back. Otherwise, they keep attacking, no, we're not going to do anything. These anti-terrorism laws, they're part of this, right? They're to help prevent terrorist attacks.
What? Like the ones last night? Yeah, well, I was watching a report on the BBC last night about... No, you're alright, thanks, buddy, cheers. So I was watching a report on the BBC last night about the survivors and how almost every single one of them in that attack lost a relative. And that these are innocent people, they're in the wrong place at a wrong time. It makes me pretty angry, yeah?
Well, yeah.
When I think about it, they go to all these lengths to stop people getting into the airports, putting body scanners up, making you take your boots off. And as far as what I'm concerned, if you want to blow something up, you'll be able to do it.
Boys, what are you talking about?
Well, did you hear what happened last night?
Well, the terrorist attacks.
Yeah, those fuckers.
Fucking hell. You know what, someone needs to teach these wankers a lesson. An eye for a fucking eye, you know what I'm saying? They bomb a plane, we take out a whole fucking village. Job done.
Yeah, all right, Goebbels, chill out. What's got your going? Not lose you like this.
Yeah, well, things change, don't they?
Like what?
Bollocks. I lost my job today.
Oh, buddy.
Oh, man.
Oh, what happened? That's all right. Well, the company are laying people off, and it just looks like I'm one of the first to go.
Really sorry to hear that, mate.
Thanks.
What are you going to do?
I'm going to shoot some fucking terrorists.
Oh, seriously?
Being deadly fucking serious.
You're just being bitter, mate. Now cheer up.
Look, we can always find you another job. No problem.
Oh, cheers, guys. Right. Come on, just ignore me. It's all right.
Oh, girls. Hi. How you doing? You all right?
Yeah. Cheer up, guys. It's Friday.
Emily, Leon's just lost his job.
Oh, I'm sorry. What happened?
You know what, guys? I'd really rather not talk about it, all right? I just want to get hammered and have a good night. Come on. Let's just drink up.
Yeah, cheers, guys.
Happy Friday.
Cheers. Happy Fridays.
Good night.
Good night, buddy.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Good
night.
See you later, guys.
Food. It's got to be food.
Yeah.
Food.
Food. Leon, do you need a lift?
No, I'm all right. I'll walk home.
Leon, you're in no condition to walk. Come on, get the car. I'll give you a lift home.
Emily, I said I'm all right. Okay. I'll see you later. I would prefer to walk if you don't mind.
You know, I sometimes think you can't forgive me for not having died that night. You hate me, don't you?
Don't be silly, Em. I don't hate you.
What is it then? You've been avoiding me since then. You barely speak to me now.
Of course I do.
No, you don't. I've kept quiet until now because I knew you were going through a lot, but I've had it. Enough is enough. I've done nothing wrong and you're punishing me.
Okay, you know what? Every time I see you, I see her dying. You were with her in her final moments, and I wasn't. And I know that's not your fault, and I know that. I do, I promise. But I cannot forgive you for that. She belonged to me, and I should have been with her. I should have died with her.
You're drunk. You don't mean that.
I am not drunk.
Yes, you are.
No, I'm not. And I do mean that. I don't care anymore. Tell me what I should care about. There's nothing left for me anymore. There's nothing left.
You are drunk. I'm getting in the fucking car. I'm taking you home.
Come on.
Oh, shit, Emily.
Yes, investigations are still underway and will continue for some time.
The fear amongst the general public is high. Is there anything you wish to share with the British people today to allay their fears?
Yeah. This latest attack shows that we're still under a real and serious threat to the UK from international terrorism. And I'd like to take this opportunity to ask the public, remain vigilant, carry on reporting suspicious events to the authorities. We really need the public to work with the police and the security services to help them in their continuing effort to infringe and discover terrorist activities.
Thank you, Prime Minister. Reports suggest that there are other splinters to the terrorist cell of Anwar Abdel Hussein still operating in this country. Our next report shows that the public is indeed very alert and determined to prevent another tragedy like the recent one. A terrorist suspect was arrested 20 miles east of the crash site today. He was apprehended at the train station, where some members of the public alerted the police that he was acting suspiciously. Three units were dispatched and the police were able to arrest the suspect without any resistance. At the moment...
Ismay Leon, Enna Arif, 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 Ismak A. Thank you.
Hello, Liam, mate. How you doing? Ricky Spandler, I'm your handler. Come with me, son, all right? Now, come with me and we'll get you sorted. I'll take you somewhere to get you fitted and kitted, right? Now, as long as you don't take the piss, I can get you a good deal on something. Right, now, you look like a bit of a revolver man to me, am I right? A couple of shots in the dark, down to the nearby river, walk off into the night, no questions asked, am I right? Yeah, I thought so. Now, this guy's got connections extremely low places. He can get you exactly what you want. Hello, Ackman, son, how you doing? How's the wife and kids, all right? It's all right, he's a mate of mine. Also, a fucking TV little git that catches you with your trousers down. Right, he can get your drugs, mugs, slugs and bugs. Kalashnikovs, Artex, Semtex and their fucking sex. Just keep your mouth shut, keep them sweet and let me do the talking. And don't rip him off, otherwise he'll rip your ass right in half, all right? Right, here we are. Hey, Mukhiya, salam alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam.
It's the guy I told you about. Wants to have a look at some weaponry.
Dia AK-47 Adima. Dia Mush Batala. Dia Aher Model.
AK-47, very nice.
It looks good. How much?
Become the.
El hitta diya, 400 guinea.
500. Get the cash. Nice doing business with you.
Muchakirin.
Right, Liam. Done deal, son. You happy?
Yeah, thanks for your help, Ricky. Thank you.
All you got to remember now? Keep your head down and cover your arse, all right?
Jesus, what the hell was that?
Fuck, man, one more. Don't
move.
Thank you.
Who's there?
My name is Thomas. You have nothing to fear from me.
What do you want?
I saw the fire and was hoping to find someone who could provide me with some food and water. May I sit down?
Have some, please. My name's Leon. What are you doing here? I asked you a question.
I had some business to take care of.
In the desert?
Yeah. In the desert. Are you a soldier?
It's a very flattering way of describing me.
What do you mean?
I was chasing a guy who deserved a bullet in the head.
Me too.
Really? God, who are you after?
People who have committed acts of terror. They left nothing but ashes and despair.
God, I know. I mean, someone's got to do something about it, haven't they? It's just so much harder than I thought it would be. I mean, I did some research on the internet, and I thought that would be enough, but I guess I was pretty naive to think that.
Internet?
Yeah, loads of different websites. To be honest, I don't even think I'm doing the right thing anymore. I guess I was pretty stupid to think that I could do it in the first place. So far, I've been shot at. I've got lost in a sandstorm and, good start.
A sandstorm?
Yeah, a couple of hours ago. Got lost and I ended up here.
A couple of hours ago. What you're trying to achieve here?
I was hoping I could make a difference, I guess. I don't know. I just want to get my life back on track.
What was your life like?
My wife and I are... our life together, it was good. It was great. She was the kindest, sweetest person I've ever known.
So what has changed?
She died. She died.
I know what you're going through, my friend. It will get better, but it will never go away. The sooner you realize this, the better. That is the thing with people who touch us. They become part of us. And it is impossible for us not to feel as being part of them, even if they are not here. That is the part that gives us joy when things go well. It is also the part that gives us immense sadness when things go wrong.
Sounds like you've lost somebody too, Thomas.
I've lost many people in this war.
It is a war, isn't it?
So what happened to your wife?
She went away with the girls for a weekend. It was her best friend's 30th birthday, and they all decided to head down to Cardiff. She was the driver on the way back, and a car went directly into the driver's side. They say that she died instantly, which is a blessing.
So when did this happen?
It's almost a year now.
It takes time.
She sent me a postcard from Cardiff. It arrived after she died.
And then, that nearly broke me in two when I came home and I found that in the post.
It would have thrown anyone, Leon.
God, I don't know why I'm telling you this. I don't even know you.
Sometimes it is easier to talk to a stranger.
Yeah, I guess you're right. And I've got good friends at home, great friends, in fact, but I just try so hard to keep it from them because I know how much they want me to move on. But it's hard.
Is that why you're here?
I don't have anything else to lose.
You're wrong. How can you give up?
I did try hanging in there, believe it or not. I sold my house. I sold our house. I bought a new one. I thought that that would give me a fresh start. And I lost my job. Well, I just decided to try something new. Look at what happened.
It is not that simple. You fail because you give up. We grow most in those difficult times. I'm sure you've experienced that. I take it you are not a soldier, you're not trained for battle or to kill anyone.
I took some shooting lessons.
How can you expect to succeed if you don't actually know what you are doing? At least this kind of thing to people who know what they're doing.
I guess you're right. Ouch.
You got courage. But courage paired with ignorance is never a good combination.
You know what, Tom? I think you've hit the nail on the head. And you know you're right. All of this, you're right. But I cannot change anything that happened to my wife. Do you see that?
Of course you can. What would she have thought about you giving up on life because of her death? Keep her in your heart in a healthy way. Don't die before your time.
I don't know. I just don't know. How about you, Thomas? You said you'd lost many people in this war. What keeps you going? You seem pretty content with life.
I focus on my duties. It took a lot of time and effort. Unaccountable attempts. But I did not give up. I succeeded.
You mean you killed one of the guys you were after?
I killed two.
Two? How the fuck did you do that?
I think it is better that we don't talk about it. Won't understand, Leon.
Come on, try me.
No, I think we'd better leave it.
Pulling my chain, you didn't kill anybody, did you?
No, I did.
Okay, when?
On the 5th of August.
Okay, 5th of August, right, so that's what? That's what, 8 weeks ago? That's 2 months ago. So why don't I remember any of this? You are, you're fucking winding me up.
No, I'm not. I killed some.
Who? Who did you kill?
A General Montgomery on Winston Churchill.
General Montgomery and British Prime Minister Winston Churchill. Thomas, no, they died long ago.
Yeah, because I killed some.
No, you didn't. They're long dead and gone. What the fuck are you talking about?
Never mind. You are not the first person to think I am crazy. Or telling lies.
Do you ever consider they might have a point?
Doesn't matter. I've been on quite a journey since I left my own time. There are many obstacles that I could not foresee, but I overcome them. And we won the war.
What are you talking about, Thomas? Your own time? Which war?
In 1940. That's where I come from, Leon. I traveled to the future to kill Winston Churchill and General Montgomery here in the desert on the 5th of August, 1942.
So you're a time traveler.
I don't know, Tom. I mean, forgive my ignorance.
We discovered that Winston Churchill and General Montgomery would meet in the Egyptian desert on the 5th of August, 1942. All I had to do was to position myself there and be ahead of them.
Right, so you changed the future. My present, but I've been completely unaffected. So why don't I remember this, Thomas? Am I in some form of time-traveling orb? What's going on?
It's the sandstorm, perhaps.
Sandstorm. That makes no sense.
I have to leave you now.
Thomas, you're fucking with me. You're winding me up. Thomas, please, just stop, all right? Let's just start from scratch. All right, come on, God knows I could do with a company. I've got a load of these disgusting instant coffees. And we can share.
It is true, Leon. Germany won the Second World War. I'm sorry.
Traveling Nazi. Poor bastard. I hope he's okay. Thomas, what the fuck? I mean, I know the beans were disgusting last night, but there's no need to fucking shoot at me! Thomas? Thomas!
I know you. I can't remember.
Thomas, of course you do. I mean, you remember the campfire last night, right? I mean, you and I, we sat together, we talked. I mean, it all got a little weird when you started talking about the whole time-travelling thing, but, you know.
It just happens, you see.
Well, that you forget things? Yeah, I can see why that would be a problem. I think you need help, Tom.
I keep bouncing back and forth. I don't know what is happening!
I mean, why don't we walk together? I mean, whereabouts are you heading to now?
I must find them.
Who?
What year is this?
Oh, for God's sake, Tom, don't start this again. It's 2012. We went through this last night.
2012? What year is das für eine verdammte Scheiße? I don't understand what is happening.
I don't know what is happening.
I keep going to the wrong time.
Thomas, for goodness sake, don't start this old time-traveling crap again.
Where the hell does this obsession come from?
It is not an obsession. It is my duty.
You haven't done it yet, have you? If it's any consolation, you guys are doing pretty well. Vorsprung durch Technik and all that. You're respected, even though you didn't win the war.
Germany will win the war.
No, Thomas. You won't. You're dying. And your friends will perish with you. Sorry, Tom. Sorry.
must have ceased to sow, so we all should go together when we go. It's not my idea of heaven to be in a state of constant flow, but when off goes a bomb, you know I'll be gone. In Christ knows where, I don't know. It's all so much a chore,
I'm